In my previous video, I shared how I track hundreds of weather balloons that are launched every day around the world and how I hunted down some of them. Overall, that was a very fun experience, and I certainly recommend everyone to at least track one of them in their life. Not just because the hardware itself is pretty interesting, but also it was an amazing experience. You can check that video by clicking the card on the right corner. At the end of my video, I also uploaded classic blink Arduino code to one of the weather balloon tracker that I found. And I promised to show how I converted this Radiosondes to powerful Arduino boards. After watching this video, you can program your free, high-end Arduino boards, which literally came from the space. First of all, I recommend you to check the GitHub link that I put in the description. The model of the weather balloon tracker that I am using is the RS41 Radiosondes. And in this well-organized GitHub page, you can find every details about the hardware available, including reverse engineered circuit diagrams. For example, if you would like to make a project which uses GPS or radio communication, you can check relevant circuit diagrams here. For programming, you need to use XData and programming connectors. If you scroll down, you can find that information in the website as well. Radiosondes has an STM32F100C8 microcontroller in it, and this is an ARM 32-bit Cortex M3 CPU core microcontroller. To be able to program the microcontroller, you need an ST-Link programmer. You can find a cheap Chinese clone very easily on the internet. After that, you can simply connect it to the relevant front-end pins. To be able to program the microcontroller, you need to connect VCC pin to 3.3 volt and ground to ground, and SWDO pin to SWDO pin, and SW clock pin to SW clock pin. To be able to communicate with the microcontroller through serial port, you need to connect RX pin to TX pin and TX pin to RX pin with a serial port module. You need to install STM32 Cube programmer to be able to program the microcontroller. I had issues with it, and as a solution, I was recommended to install Java in my computer to install the STM32 Cube programmer. After installing Java, you can download STM32 Cube programmer from the original website and install it as usual. I have already installed it before, so I will skip this step. After opening the program, you will see this screen. If you click the connect button and try to read the contents of the microcontroller, you won't be able to do that, because the microcontroller is read protected. A quick warning, if you do following steps, you will erase the existing firmware on the Radiosondes. To fix the read protection issue, you need to remove the read protection from the microcontroller. Also, you need to remove write protection as well by checking all the relevant checkboxes. Then don't forget to click apply button. If you try to read the chip again, you can do that right now. Since the microcontroller is erased, all of the chip will have nothing on it, of course. After this, click full chip erase button, and then you will have a fresh chip that you can upload your programs on. I connected a ST-Link and also serial port adapter to my PC at the same time. Last time, I have already did a blink code, so I wanted to do something else this time. This Radiosondes have a GPS module, so maybe a GPS project might be more interesting than a blink code. After checking the circuit diagram on the GitHub page, I wrote a simple GPS code in Arduino IDE. This code will provide my location and also GPS clock at the same time. As you see, if I open the serial monitor in Arduino IDE, I can see my current location and also GPS clock as well. Sweet! You can also install an Arduino bootloader if you want, but I don't see any benefits at all. That's why I didn't mention about it in the video. But it is of course your call. I will leave the link if you want to go that route. If you want to explore other projects, I strongly recommend other projects on the GitHub. Just type RS41 on the search bar and see how many projects show up. And if you have other ideas, you can do that with that Arduino too. See you next time!